subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of these stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. One of the most popular and auspicious festivals in India, Ganesh Chaturthi, is a perfect mixture of culture, history and vibrancy. Celebrated in the honour of God of Wisdom, Lord Ganesha, it is a much-awaited occasion, especially in the southern and western parts of the country. Though it is observed in a grand manner every year, but this time amid the pandemic, its celebration were kept a low-key affair.
Huge idols of Lord Ganesha, crowded tents and chants of Ganpati Bappa Moraya, reverberating in the air. All this marks the celebrations of the most resplendent festival of Ganesh Chaturthi in India. Every year, people set up huge pandals, a temporary shed where they install a beautifully crafted idol of the elephant-headed god. But this time, amid the virus outbreak, the celebrations were quite sober. Though the Ganesh temples were decorated in a grand manner, but only a limited number of devotees were allowed to enter. They were asked to wear masks, sanitize their hands, and practice social distancing to avoid the spread of infection.
Tengin kai Ganapati madidro ee varsha corona irodinda sarp yenu maada illa simple aagi madidare manel pooja martidivi ella safety gagi mask use maadi sanitizer use maadi ellarigu olledagi manel chenage celebrate madidivi but illi mohodarsha tara illa ಹೋದರ್ಷ ತುಂಬ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಈ ವರ್ಷ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಬಟ್
ಕೊರೋನಾ ವೈರಸ್ ಥೀಮ್ಡ್ ಡೆಕೋರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ದಿ ಗಣಪತಿ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೂರತ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್ ಅ ಪಂಡಾಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಡ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಮೆಸೇಜಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ನಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಅಡೇರ್ ಅಮಿಡ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾಂಡಮಿಕ್ It even paid tribute to frontline warriors who are working day and night to help the country deal with the effects of virus. A similar setup was erected by a lady in her house in the state's Vadodara city. Named as Corona Warriors, the Ganesh Mandap showed the police, sanitation staff, doctors and medical staff at the hospital as well as media on duty during the lockdown as a part of the decorations. Moreover, ranging from the models of hospitals to each and every item placed on the mandap was made from paper, making the whole structure completely eco-friendly.
ये इसीलिए कि जो फ्रंटलाइन वॉरियर्स है हम लोगों ने जो सर्विस दी है उनको ट्रिब्यूट देने के लिए गणपति के थ्रू हम लोगों ने ये डेकोरेशन किया है।
Though this year people could not have grand celebrations, but they still managed to keep the festive spirit alive. In Rajkot city, devotees offered prayers, sang hymns, and cooked 56 types of different dishes, including sweets, fruits, vegetables, among other items in their homes to appease the Lord Ganesha.
कोरोना का माहौल है इसलिए गणपति बाहर कुछ बड़ा वाला नहीं हुआ है, छोटा छोटा सबके घर में होता है, ऐसा वाला हमने भी सब घर में लगाया है। वो 5 साल से हम रह रहे गणपति का स्थापन कर रहे हैं और गणपति में सब 56 भोग गणपति को खुश करने के लिए, आनंद में रखने के लिए गणपति को 56 भोग धराया है।
Historical records suggest that Ganesh Chaturthi celebrations were initiated by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj to promote culture and nationalism. However, it remained a family affair until freedom fighter Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak organized Ganesh Utsav in 1893. Every year, the festivities of Ganesh Chaturthi go on for 10 days and on the last day, the idols are taken through the streets in a procession and immersed in a river or sea. This immersion symbolizes seeing off of Ganesh's journey towards his abode, taking away with him the misfortunes of all mankind.
The festivals in India do not just offer a temporary reprieve from the daily grind, but also serve as a medium to promote peace and brotherhood as people from across faiths gather at one place to commemorate the event. This bond of religious harmony was recently visible during the celebrations of Ganesh Chaturthi and Muharram that draw different communities together at various parts of the country. Take a look.
At one side, where Ganesha idol was enshrined, on the other, Muharram's panje, also known as protective hands, were placed at the same pandal in Hubli city of Karnataka's Dharwad district. Presenting a perfect example of communal harmony, both the Hindu and Muslim community in this Bidnal village of Hubli have been carrying forward this tradition for the last several years. Having a mixed population of around 4,000, the village is well known to maintain harmony and stay with each other in both good and bad times.
हम लोग वही परंपरा आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं, सब लोग हिंदू मुस्लिम सब मिलके ये खुशी से त्यौहार बना रहे हैं। ये खुशी की त्यौहार ऐसा ही रहना चाहिए।
बिडनाल एक अजनबी ऐसा गांव है, यहाँ पर हिंदू हिंदू नहीं, मुसलमान मुसलमान नहीं है, दोनों मिला एक धर्म बनता है। हम कौन सी नहीं है, अगर वो हिंदू अगर मुसलमान है तो दोनों मिलकर देखो मजा आती है। हम ये नहीं सोचते कि हम मुसलमान है अगर वो हिंदू है, सबसे हम ये सोचते हैं कि हम अल्लाह के बंदे हैं।
Meanwhile, in Hyderabad city of Telangana, a similar show of unity was witnessed when a Hindu family installed Tazia at their residence to observe Muharram, the first month of the Islamic calendar. Tazia is a replica of the tomb of Hussein, the martyred grandson of Prophet Muhammad, that is carried in processions during Muharram. The residents of this Rani Ganj area in the city observe all festivals together, be it of Hindus or Muslims, and this tradition is being followed since long.
करीब करीब मैं ये 10 साल से देखते आ रहा हूँ ये रानीगंज में सब हिंदू मुस्लिम सब मिलके सब ये फेस्टिवल मनाते, कोई भेदभाव नहीं रखते, कोई अपना कोई देखते नहीं, सब आके यहाँ पर मन्नत मांगते और दुआ लेते। और ऐसो ये करीब करीब हमारे परदादा उन लोग से कर ले तैयार है, तो हम भी सोचे कि हम भी ऐसे कंटिन्यू करते रहे कि हम ये नहीं रुकना चाहते।
Such examples showcasing India's secular nature can be witnessed every now and then in our country. But it's during the occasions when this beautiful bond of friendship among all faiths get much more strengthened.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
India's Defence Research and Development Organisation, DRDO, is helping farmers of Himalayan desert region of Ladakh to grow vegetables and fruits mostly limited to warm weather areas. The arid Himalayan region has limited vegetation because of lack of water and harsh climate conditions. However, with mulching method and other technological advancements, with subsidies from local administrations, farmers are now growing seasonal vegetables and fruits too. Fay Village, located 12 km from popular tourist destination of Leh, is the first in the region to try the new methods out. It started way back in 2016 on trial basis with the help of Defence Institute of High Altitude Research, the High Altitude Research arm of DRDO.
हम ये वाटर मेलन 4 साल से लगा रहा हूँ 2016 से। पहले हमको DRDO ने ट्रेनिंग दिया, एक्सपोजर टूर कराया, ट्रेनिंग दिया उन्होंने हमको कैसे लगाना है मल्चिंग टेक्नोलॉजी में। उनने हमको ऑर्डर भी किया, उसके बाद बहुत अच्छा हो गया। पहले घर 4 घर को सेलेक्ट किया हाउस होल्डर को, उन्होंने लगाया तो बहुत अच्छा प्रोग्रेस हुआ था, क्यों हम कमाई भी बहुत हो गया। पहले तो हम सिर्फ 5 मंजिला 10 मंजिले को लगाया, अभी हम बढ़ा के 2-2 कनाल 3-3 कनाल को भी लगा रहा हूँ।
The producers are used to fulfill local demand as well as sold to the Indian Army stationed in the region, who earlier had to source food items from mainland India.
A mosque in Hyderabad city of Telangana has been converted into a community healthcare center to treat patients during the coronavirus pandemic amid a shortage of medical facilities. A part of Masjid-e-Mustafa Mosque was turned into a clinic for women and children who were being provided free treatment and medicines at a time when hospitals are swamped with patients and more temporary facilities are being opened to meet the demands.
ये कहीं भी दवाखाने में नहीं ले रहे, इतनी नहीं परेशानी हो रही है, मामूली से खांसी बुखार पैरों में दर्द कुछ भी है तो कहीं भी दवाखाने में नहीं ले रहे। ये जो दवाखाना खोले बहुत आरामी हुई।
Amid the pandemic, a number of people, organizations and religious centers across the country have come up and contributed their bit to help the society deal with the effects of the virus.
Students in Budgam district of Jammu and Kashmir, who have no access to internet facilities, are attending open-air classes to catch up on their studies after schools were closed following the coronavirus outbreak 5 months ago. Students now have an open lush green field as classrooms where boxes have been drawn to maintain distance and teachers conduct lessons against the backdrop of the Himalayas under a crystal blue sky.
I हम ऑनलाइन क्लास इसलिए दे नहीं पाते क्योंकि हमारे मोहल्ले में जो भी लोग हैं वो बहुत गरीब है, इसीलिए वो स्मार्टफोन नहीं खरीद सकते, इसीलिए हमको ये ऑनलाइन क्लासेस नहीं दे सकते हमारे लिए वो हमारे पास वो फैसिलिटीज़ नहीं है हम ऑनलाइन क्लासेस दे सके।
These community classes are organized across various districts of the Union Territory so that the students' studies do not get affected.
A wave of spiritualism swept across the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir as it celebrated the most auspicious and ancient Mela Pat festival. Observed in the Bhaderwa area of Doda district, the festival witnesses the participation of people from almost all communities, creating a spectrum of religious diversity.
No matter which religion we follow, we are one family. These words showcasing amity between different communities resonated loudly in the Bhaderwa area of JNK's Doda district as it celebrated the famous festival of Mela Pat. Dedicated to a serpent king, Lord Vasuki Nag, the presiding deity of Bhaderwa, this three-day-long festival begins on Rishi Panchami, a traditional festival observed in the respect of seven saints who guided the mankind. People, irrespective of caste, creed and faith, participate in large numbers in Mela Pat festival, but this year, amid the pandemic, the crowd was quite less. Proper security arrangements were also made by the authorities to avoid any chaos during the event.
बहुत लिमिटेड गैदरिंग के साथ जो है यहाँ पे ये मेला पट जो है सेलिब्रेट किया गया। जैसा आप जानते हैं पिछले साल जो है यहाँ कम से कम 6-7 हज़ार लोगों की गैदरिंग रहती है, तो उस मुकाबले में इस बारी कोविड को चलते नजर देखते हुए काफ़ी कम जो है यहाँ पे लोग जमा हुए और कोविड SOPs को जो है यहाँ पे फॉलो किया गया।
ऋषि पंचमी के दिन ये मेला मनाया जाता है और ये हमारे जो वासुकी नाग देवता जी के भगत जो हमारे राजा नागपाल जी थे, उन्होंने उस वक्त के वो टाइम से महाराजा अकबर जी के टाइम से ये मेला लगता है यहाँ पर, उसको सभी धर्म के लोग अच्छी तरह से विश्वास करते हैं, मानते हैं और पूजा अर्चना करते हैं इस दिन सभी।
As a part of the celebrations, a procession is organized in which a devoted man carries the pat on his head and proceed to the compound of Vasuki Dera temple, along with people playing drums and other musical instruments. Pat is basically a heavy load of conical shape with conical metallic pot on the top, decently decorated with marigold flowers and adorned with hundreds of cloths. As they reach the temple, the traditional dance known as Mela Pat is performed before the Naga deity, and this procession later concludes at the house of Rajgurus in Khakal, a centrally located place in Bhaderwa. Dating back to 16th century, the festival commemorates the historic meet of Emperor Akbar and Raja Nagpal of Bhaderwa at Delhi.
ये मेला अकबर शासनकाल से, अकबर जो है उसके शासनकाल से चलता आ रहा है। हर 5 साल के बाद दिल्ली में उनका एक शासन लगता था, वहाँ पे सब राजा जितने भी राजा हैं पूरी इंडिया में, छोटे बड़े राजा जो भी हैं वहाँ पे जाते थे 5 साल के बाद। तो जो भद्रवाह के राजा हैं राजा नागपाल जी, तो वहाँ भी वहाँ चले गए, तो वहाँ पर जब गए तो वो सारे लोग वहाँ पर उनको झुके, उनको सलाम किया, जो भी किया, तो जो राजा नागपाल जी थे उन्होंने सलाम नहीं किया। तो अकबर ने उनको कहा कि भाई तेरे को किस चीज़ का घमंड है, जब सब राजा हमें आके झुक के कर रहे हैं तो तेरे अंदर कौन सी ऐसी शक्ति है कि तू इतना घमंड दिखा रहा है। तो उन्होंने क्या कहा, उन्होंने कहा तू कल यहाँ पे आना, अपनी जो शक्ति है उसको दिखाना, नहीं तो जो तेरा सिर है उसको धड़ से अलग कर दिया जाएगा। रात को जब वो सोए राजा नागपाल जी, उनको सपने में वासुकी नाग जी आए, उन्होंने कहा केसरी कलर का साफा लगा के एक शामली ऊपर को रखे, एक शामली नीचे को रखे। जब आप उधर जाएंगे अकबर के सामने, साफे की शामली एक ऊपर एक नीचे, नागपाल राजा जी के उन्होंने एक शामली ऊपर एक नीचे रखी। कैसे वो वहाँ पे के बोलते दिखा भाई अपनी शक्ति क्या, वासुकी नाग जी पांच गर्दन लेके प्रकट हो गए, उनके जो साफा उस पर प्रकट हो गए। जब अकबर ने वो देखा, अकबर ने बोला ये क्या है जी, अकबर ने अकबर जो है उनके सामने झुके, उन्होंने बोला वाकया मैंने वासुकी नाग जी की जो है शक्ति देखी।
These ancient traditions are not just the representations of our Indian culture, but also highlight the unity and brotherhood that prevails among different sections of the society and are still playing a major role in binding the people of various faiths together.
It is said that education is the most powerful weapon that you can use to change the world. Moving on the same lines, an NGO that started the India's first signal school in Thane city of Maharashtra 4 years ago has come a long way in imparting education to the poor and marginalized children, especially the young street dwellers.
The traffic signals under the flyover now are not just limited to the street dwellers to carry out their business, but has also become a place where the young minds take their beginning steps towards a bright future. All thanks to a Pune-based NGO Samarth Bharat Vyaspeeth that came up with this innovative concept of Signal Shala or Signal School that aims to provide mainstream education to the children living on streets. Accredited by Thane Municipal Corporation, this school operates out of a shipping container under Teen Hat Signal Flyover in Thane and provides primary and secondary education to underprivileged children by friendly learning methods.
इन बच्चों को अगर हमको पढ़ाना है तो एक ऐसी स्कूल चाहिए थी जो उनको समझ सके और उनके हिसाब से फ्लेक्सिबल हो सके। तो बच्चे स्कूल नहीं जा सकते मगर स्कूल तो बच्चे तक आ सकती है, ये बच्चों तक लाई गई स्कूल है जिसको हम लोग सिग्नल स्कूल कहते हैं।
इनॉग्रेटेड ऑन June 15, 2016, the Signal School currently imparts education to 48 children who earlier used to sell knickknacks at the traffic signals. The school has 4 full-time teachers, 1 attendant and several volunteers who keep dropping by at regular intervals to help in some way or the other. Apart from imparting mainstream education, the school also conducts activities like dance, sports and games along with honing the skills of the students in other fields like robotics.
स्कूल स्टार्ट होता है, फिर पहले पढ़ाई ये सब स्टार्ट होता है, 1 बजे तक स्टार्ट होता है, पढ़ाई होता है और फिर 1 बजे के बाद 2 बजे तक बच्चे खेलते हैं सब। और शुक्रवार और शनिवार ये 2 दिन रोबोटिक का क्लास लिया जाता है और सोमवार और मंगलवार ये दिन स्पोर्ट डे यानी स्पोर्ट खेला जाता है। तो ऐसे ही सिखाया जाता है।
Similar schools should be started at various places in the mega cities so that each and every child in India has access to education. Moreover, if children can't reach to the school, such initiatives will help the school reach to them.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIN.com. I'm your host Shreya Savichai and it's goodbye from the entire production team.